Oxford Instruments, a worldwide high-technology business, is celebrating 50 years of scientific innovation and excellence. The company was co-founded in 1959 by Martin and Audrey Wood.
I was working as an engineer in the physics department in the Clarendon Laboratory in Oxford University, involved in designing and making the magnets that were used for the research there. And I soon came to realise that there was an opportunity for supplying equipment like this to other laboratories elsewhere in the country and in the world.
We decided to form a company, and because wood magnets didn't sound very good, we decided to call it the Oxford Instrument Company. And we cleared the decks, and I took over the administration, and Martin did the construction and design.
Its first copper-wound magnet was delivered to radar research in 1961. The company grew from a spare room to a shed, then to a small disused slaughterhouse and stable.
In 1961, we went to a pivotal conference in America where superconductors were discussed for the first time.
Superconductors had the promise of being much better materials, so we could make better magnets, higher fields and cheaper and so on. And we discussed this through, and on the underground in New York later that evening, we made the tremendous decision that we'd really go ahead.
We ordered a pound of the material, and it cost more than gold at the time, and Martin wound a magnet from it.
This magnet had parts of it which enabled us to increase the market from about 10 to about 10,000 if we ran the business properly.
And they did. By 1963, they had to recruit more people with technical and manufacturing experience. Oxford Instruments had set their own mould, innovative science with its risky, cutting-edge research, and a management style that respected and valued its workforce. They became skilled at recognising good opportunities.
We decided to form a company called Oxford Cryogenics, making and delivering liquid helium all around the country.
Things really began to take off then, and we decided to move from our old premises in the slaughterhouse to some new premises we found in an old boathouse on the River Thames.
They gained a reputation for leading-edge development work, and in 1967 won the Queen's Award for Technical Innovation of Ultra-Low Temperature Instruments, which are still in demand today. Physicist Barry Marson joined as MD. With the 70s came the difficulties of an international recession, but still they won their second Queen's Award to Industry in 1972. The Oxford Instruments Company became the Oxford Instruments Group. A new range of cryostats was developed. As the company came into profit in 1974, more acquisitions were made. They moved into cardiology and EEG for recording brain signals, and Oxford Medical was formed. Oxford Instruments played a vital part in the development of MRI. In 1981, after delivery of the first MRI magnet to a London hospital, orders were received from almost every serious company in the MRI race. It had undoubtedly become the world leader in superconducting magnets. In 1982, an important joint venture agreement with BOC was signed to supply MRI magnets to the American market. Oxford Instruments' range of products and services grew dramatically. Later, a successful joint venture with Siemens was also entered into. A factory in New Jersey making superconducting wire was acquired, and the first LabX was launched. Its reputation was growing. It was time to give the group a new brand identity to strengthen and unify its image. Another recession put everyone under pressure, with 2 million unemployed. Oxford Instruments had to find cost savings and efficiencies, but MRI helped weather the storm.
MRI was our greatest opportunity to date, and we clearly needed a lot more finance to fulfil this, and we decided to go to the London Stock Exchange in 1983.
Between 1981 and 1985, orders went up from 5 million in MRI magnets to 50 million, and in that time, profits went up by an average of 57% a year.
In 1985, Oxford Magnet Technology won 2 Queen's Awards for their body-scanning magnets, the only company to win 2 awards that year. Oxford Analytical developed new NMR analyzers and in 1986 won a Queen's Award for exports. It also acquired plasma technology. In the same year, Martin received a knighthood and then, for his contribution to science, was elected a Fellow of the Royal Society. 1987 was another difficult year. Black Monday saw a major drop in share prices. But the company survived again by diversifying its product range and becoming more organized and efficient. Expansion followed with the acquisition of the Link Scientific Group, making analytical and microanalysis products. Two companies were formed, Oxford Instruments Industrial Analysis and Oxford Instruments Microanalysis Group. 1992 and yet another world recession was starting to bite, so the group businesses were consolidated onto a smaller number of sites. The geographical diversity and spread of market sectors kept the company well afloat through these years. Around 1996, the feel-good factor began to return and prospects improved. The entire company was reorganized, led by the new chairman, Nigel Keane. Three new businesses were formed: magnets and cryogenics, industrial and analytical instruments, and medical, which was sold in 2005. Jonathan Flint became chief executive, and Kevin Boyd joined as group finance director. Their objective was to double the size of the company over 5 years. The emerging nanotechnology, energy, health, security, and environmental protection markets present exciting opportunities, exploiting Oxford Instruments' core skills of working at the atomic level. It now operates in 25 countries and supplies products and services into many diverse markets. Oxford Instruments has always held the fundamental belief that scientific research and development is essential to improving the way we live. Today, the spirit of innovation and excellence that is at the heart of the company continues. But it's the skills and dedication of its people that have always been the key to its success. The future matters, and Oxford Instruments is part of that future.